Megapixelem jsme se osobně vydali na představení velké novinky, která se stala milníkem v technologii fotoaparátu. Podařilo se nám také natočit exkluzivní rozhovor se zástupcem společnosti Sony a také jsme měli příležitost si tuto novinku otestovat na velice zajímavém místě. A kam jsme to vlastně až jeli? K tomu si musíme trošičku vrátit v čase.
Ahoj, já jsem Matyáš, videospecialista z Megapixelu a dneska vás zdravím až z dalekého Turecka. A proč jsme vlastně tady? To si povíme za chvilku.
Nejsme tady totiž na žádné dovolené.
The never-ending challenge. A single photo to change views. A single photo to make history. In an age overwhelmed by motion, sometimes it's only a single powerful frame that can tell the whole story. For photographers who believe in the power of one frame, the challenge of Alpha continues. The new 9. Alpha 9 Mark 3.
Já vás vítám na konferenci Sony, kam jsme se s Megapixelem přijeli podívat na představení novinky, a to Sony A9 III a nového objektivu 300 mm f2.8.
Alpha.
Now I have to quickly switch to English because I would like to introduce you to the head of IPNS marketing, Mr. Jan Salmon Le Garnier. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you, Matthias, for inviting me.
Thank you very much. Could you tell us what products have Sony introduced today?
So today is a big milestone for Sony. We have put several milestones with the full frame in mirrorless, but also with Alpha 9. But today is a new milestone with the Alpha 9 Mark III with the global shutter. So big news for Sony, but also for the industry.
Very true. Could you specify key aspects of each product?
Of course, of course everything rotates around this global shutter. So global shutter basically bring you a new era of photography in terms of speed. So we're introducing a camera that is able to shoot 120 frames per second, but this with autofocus, auto exposure, in RAW, in JPEG, full quality, and that is something that has never seen before. It's also have the new AI chip that is enabling to track the focus all the time during 120 frames per second with no absolutely delay on the focus. It's absolutely amazing. No blackout in the viewfinder. Then the other benefit of the new global shutter is also the speed of the shutter as well, because you can shoot at 1/80,000 of a second and synchronize the flash with this shutter speed. And that is an amazing new feature in the world of the photography, because before you were obviously limited by your shutter speed at the synchro flash speed of the camera. that was usually around 1/200, sometimes on 1/300 at the best. Now any speed up to 1/80,000 is possible in flash photography. The camera also comes with new innovation in terms of workflow for the professional photographer in the tagging system with IPTC. We also have new protocols for transferring images. So overall, the camera has been built for professional use, but also specifically for sports photographer and news photographer. So it's a really powerful piece of kit.
Would you say, is it also okay to use it for a video?
Yeah, so video, of course, is not the main positioning, but it's a good question because global shutter also mean that you don't have any delay on the sensor. So jelly effect, for example, that we know very well in video and that everybody hates, is now old story. And the camera is indeed capable of shooting really, really fast. So it's a 6K oversampling in video and enable also to shoot in the end in 4K 120p, but that without any cropping. So this also means that if you shoot in 4K 24p or 25p, 60p or up to 120p, you will always have the same framing, meaning in post-production, you will have no change in the framing, and that's really a big advantage. You don't have headache about the framing you have shot in different frame rates, as an example. And as I mentioned, of course, no distortion is one of the biggest advantage as well.
Mm-hmm. And you kind of said it already, but what is the target audience? Which kind of photographer would appreciate this camera the most?
Yeah, it's a fair question. So of course, by the positioning of the camera and also the specs, it will ring a bell immediately for sports photographer. So that will be the first target group. But of course, we have so many passionate of photography using Sony or not yet using Sony that will start to think about wildlife photography as well, as an example. Other area that still kind of are completely uncharted, that we don't even realize the potential, is studio photography. No flash synchronization issue whatsoever. In the past, when you needed to synchronize at higher speed, shutter speed, you needed to have very long flash sequence to cover the shutter time. So you need a lot of power, and the synchronization was an absolutely nightmare. Now a studio photographer can go in the studio, put very normal light and shoot at the speed he or she wants, as it wants. And you can shoot outdoor, full aperture and with the sunlight, putting a fill-in flash at 1/80,000 seconds, and you have it and it works.
That's
quite big as well.
That's very big. Okay, and what about the lens that was introduced?
So we introduced a long-awaited, I have to admit, 300mm f2.8 G Master. So that basically complete our collection of long lenses for sport photographer and wildlife photographer for the 300, 400 and 600. So we have now, I would call it the trinity of the tele lenses in the lineup. So that's also an amazing news, I think.
Mm-hmm. Thank you very much and we will see you at testing.
Právě jsme ukončili úvodní prezentaci a školení a nyní budeme mít příležitost si tělo i objektiv vyzkoušet. Tak pojďme na to. Právě jsme měli příležitost otestovat tento stroj na různých sportovních aktivitách. A musím říct, že sportovním fotografům už neunikne jediný okamžik. Pojďte se podívat, jak to probíhalo. Bam, 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 bam Právě jsme měli tu příležitost otestovat tento stroj na různých sportovních disciplínách. A musím říct, že sportovním fotografu neunikne jediný moment.
Oh, he almost dropped it.
Megapixel. Největší na foto a video.